Also part of the EPC semifinal doubleheader, two more district qualifiers who were trying to punch their ticket to the league finals as the 13-3 Liberty Hurricanes would go toe-to-toe with the 13-1 Emmaus Green Hornets. Breland Moore has the story.
Yesterday afternoon, the EPC semifinals were underway at Easton Area Middle School. The 11-1 Emmaus Green Hornets took on 11-2 Liberty for the chance to play for the league title. The game gets underway, and it's clear that this one will be tough for both teams. Brett Bozak picks up the service ace here, and the Canes will take a slight lead. But of course, like the name of the game, the points will volley between the two squads. After several back and forths, Carson Landis will finally kill for the Emmaus point as the Green Hornets take set one, 26-24. In set two, Liberty will once again give their opponent a run for their money. Logan Priestess will bump, Jake Gallagher will set, and Bozak will kill as the Canes take an early lead. The Green Hornets will come back once again, though. Here comes James Hagg on the kill as they take set two, 25-22. Unfortunately for Liberty, this contest will only go three sets. Emmaus' Carson Landis will come in for the kill as they'll take the third and final set by a score of 25-18. Emmaus advances to the EPC final with a final score of 3-0.
I thought we played well. We had a few points in the game where we got down, but you know, we battled back and played as a team, and that contributed to our success tonight.
It was a good match. You know, I expected them to battle. They did. We got in a hole early. We're able to dig out, so I think that helped my guys realize that, you know, they can play from behind and pull out the victory.
After being swept by their crosstown rivals, Emmaus has one more shot now to go toe-to-toe with what they refer to as the 800-pound gorilla in the room. They'll take on the Parkland Trojans during the EPC final. And although they're well aware that this is definitely a David and Goliath type of situation, the Green Hornets are feeling confident and ready to hit them with their best shot.
You know, we're excited for the opportunity. Every chance we get to play them, you know, we feel like we have a better shot at beating them. We're ready. We're going to practice hard tomorrow and be ready for the game Wednesday, whoever we play, Whitehall or Parkland. You know, we're really happy with our performance tonight, but it's going to lead into tomorrow or to Wednesday, and we're going to hope to get a good result Wednesday.
Well, I'm out here to help my seniors get a win. They've been here 4 years trying to get a win against Parkland. Hopefully we can do it for them. If we play against Parkland like we played today, I think we should have a good shot. Hopefully we're on a roll, and I guess that's a big goal of our team, to beat Parkland.
It's a tough team. We've told the boys all season, you know, they can't make a lot of mistakes, so we've got to play a smart game, make sure we're not giving them a lot of points. You know, we can get away with that against some teams, but you're not going to get away with that against Parkland, so we got to make sure we're playing a smart game. I think we have the pieces. You know, again, they've just got to believe they can do it, and they've got to make sure that, you know, they're hitting their spots defensively, that they're hitting smart instead of just pounding it into that big block. So, you know, we're definitely going to work on it, and hopefully we've got a shot.
On the scene at Easton Area Middle School, Breland Moore, to sports.
All right, should be a good one, a rematch of last year's title game, and the Trojans, who had an undefeated season last year en route to the state title. Their last loss actually came to Emmaus, but it was in April of 2014. So some good ones, good matchup to watch tomorrow night. Whitehall and Liberty also still in action in district playoffs as well. We'll stick around when we come.